Hi, my name is Jeremy, and this is the new DJI Air 3, and we've had it for a couple months now. It's a very interesting drone with its own very peculiar set of features. It's definitely a big upgrade from the Air 2S because it's now got omnidirectional sensors, which is a really cool safety feature to have, and we'll show you why in a bit. It's got two new cameras now instead of one, and it's got a brand new video transmission system called Occusync 4, which will allow you to control this drone from 20 kilometers away. But despite all those new features, we can't seem to figure out who this drone is actually designed for. You see, the DJI Air 3 has got almost the same features as the Mini 4 Pro. But it's a much heavier drone, weighing more than 250 grams, which means you may have to register this thing depending on where you live. So effectively, this rules out the DJI Air 3 from being an entry-level drone for beginners. Now, on the flip side, the DJI Air 3 also shares a lot of similarities with the Mavic 3 Pro, a drone that is mainly aimed at professionals. But the Air 3 is lighter, more affordable. However, its camera system may not be as good as the Mavic 3's. So what you have is a capable drone with intelligent safety features that comes with a decent quality camera, decently priced for beginners, but it's not for beginners. So who is the DJI Air 3 designed for? Well, hopefully in this video, we'll help you work out what are the major differences and whether the new DJI Air 3 is the drone for you. So let's dive into it. Now, the main difference between the DJI Air 3 and the Mavic 3 Pro is the camera, or should I say, cameras. The folded sensor on the Mavic 3 is the largest camera sensor fitted onto a foldable drone, which gives it the best image quality. This is the creme de la creme, and it also produces the best low-light performance. This thing has even got variable aperture control. And if you've got the Mavic 3 Pro, it even comes with two additional telephoto cameras, which will let you shoot at 3x zoom and 7x zoom, which will give you endless opportunities to frame up your shots. Now, the camera sensor on the Air 3 is smaller. It's just a 1x1.3-inch sensor, which is the same size sensor used on flagship smartphones such as the Samsung Galaxy S23 Ultra. This is also the same sensor from the Mini 4 Pro. And they both can shoot images up to 48 megapixels. And videos up to 4K at 100 frames. 4K videos at 100 frames is really incredible because you can now shoot slow motion videos without having to go down to a lower resolution. And for people producing content for social media, the DJI Air 3 also offers vertical video. Unfortunately, the gimbal on the Air 3 doesn't tilt 90 degrees like on the Mini 4 Pro. So, what you're getting is just a 2.7K vertical crop. Look, on the bright side, you still get 2.7K, which is still more resolution than 1080p. Now, when it comes to sensor size, the 1x1.3-inch sensor is smaller when compared to the 1-inch sensor on the Air 2S. But despite being a smaller sensor, it is surprisingly much better at low-light performance than the 1-inch sensor. Which is probably why DJI have decided to drop the 1-inch sensor and give the Air 3 two of these smaller sensors. There's one for the wide shot at 1x zoom and the other for the 3x telephoto. And just like the triple camera setup on the Mavic 3 Pro, I think the DJI Air 3 with its dual camera setup will also give you plenty of options to frame up different style of shots. And I think a lot of people will find the telephoto lens to be very useful as you don't always want to fly too close to your subject.
You're trying to kill me! You're trying to kill me!
To be fair, if you didn't move back, wait, I stopped right before you, don't worry.
The folded sensor on the Mavic 3 series will always be the best. For now. But if you can compromise a bit on quality, then maybe the DJI Air 3 could be the drone for you. And this is because when you compare the specs of the aircraft, the Mavic 3 and the Air 3 pretty much have the same specs. It's just that the Air 3 is a bit skinnier. So, let's take a closer look at the specs. First of all, both these aircraft have omnidirectional sensors, which allows the drone to see its surroundings so that it can make corrections mid-flight to help you avoid flying into things. On the Air 2S, the Air 3's older brother, it could only detect objects from the front or from the back. So, whenever you're flying sideways on the Air 2S to do a side profile shot, the Air 2S, in fact, would not have known what was coming at it from the side. So, if there was a wall or a tree, you're most likely going to end up hitting it, because the Air 2S would not have known it was there. Whereas on the DJI Air 3, it's got all these dome-shaped cameras peppered all around its body. Just like on the Mavic 3, these tiny cameras are what makes it possible for the Air 3 to have a 360 view of its surroundings. And when you couple that 360 vision with object recognition software, this is what makes the DJI Air 3 intelligent enough to see 3D objects in the real world. And because it's able to recognize 3D objects, the DJI Air 3 can now start making its own decision on how to avoid crashing into things.
The drone aiming directly into his head. You're gonna push forward.
So instead of flying forward and hitting the human subject, the Air 3 has decided to go around it. I think it's a really cool safety feature, and it kind of reminds me of Tesla's autopilot. Granted, it's still not great in detecting branches, so do be careful, because those things are just too fine for the dome cameras to pick up. But hopefully in the future, these drones will just get smarter. But hopefully, not too smart. Now, apart from omnidirectional sensors, the Mavic 3 and the Air 3 do have a lot more in common. They both have incredible battery life and are rated for a flight time of 46 minutes, which means you'll have plenty of time to get your shots done before needing to come back down for another fresh battery. And if you order the Air 3 with the fly mode combo, you'll even receive this new charging hub, which is of course used for charging multiple batteries at the same time. But it also has this new feature that lets you transfer the residual power from your used battery to be accumulated into the battery with the highest leftover charge. This is so that when you're nowhere near a charging station, this feature could get you back up in the air for one last flight to capture that crucial shot. And I think a lot of people will find it very handy. Thank you, DJI. This is a great idea. Now, another thing that the DJI Air 3 and the Mavic 3 have in common is top speed. And you'll be glad to know that it can keep up with a Lamborghini, but only up to 75 kilometers per hour. However, this is not really why you need top speed. You see, during windy conditions, you need a drone that can fly faster than the wind speed. Because if your drone can't do that, well, it'll slowly start drifting away and it'll soon be gone with the wind. So in a way, to be able to top out at 75 kilometers per hour is a safety feature. And it's a feature that you won't find on the Mini 4 Pro. Now, in the unlikely event that your DJI Air 3 does drift away, you could, theoretically, still be in contact with your Air 3. And that's because DJI says that the new Air 3 uses Occusync 4, which will allow you to maintain control of your drone up to 20 kilometers away. And that's because DJI claims that Occusync 4 has more range than Occusync 3. And if that claim was true, you could, theoretically, fly your DJI Air 3 from Europe to Africa. Which is really crazy when you think about it. DJI claims that this is all down to this new controller, the DJI RC2, which uses Occusync 4, the new video transmission that will soon replace Occusync 3. Now, at first glance, this controller may look exactly like the older controller that comes with the Mini 3 Pro, but with one major difference. But apart from that, this controller still uses the 5.5-inch display that outputs 700 nits of brightness. And there's a fan in there now, because you can feel the airflow when you put your fingers behind the controller. So, we suspect the processor inside the controller may have been beefed up, and it now requires cooling. And, as a result, it now has a battery life of 3 hours instead of 4. Now, if you prefer a brighter screen, you could get the DJI Air 3 with the RCN2 controller. This controller looks exactly like the RCN1 controller first released back in April 2020, when it was still using Occusync 2.0. This new controller uses Occusync 4 and is currently only compatible with the Mini 4 Pro and the DJI Air 3. And with this controller, you could bring in your favorite display, and these days with flagship smartphones outputting 2000 nits of brightness, this could be your ideal setup if you don't mind fiddling with wires and juggling with holding multiple things at the same time. Look, we're really bad when it comes to losing camera equipment, and sometimes having too many things can be very chaotic, especially when you're packing up and things are just all over the place, which is why we love the simplicity and convenience that the DJI RC2 provides. Because it has a built-in display, all you have to do is screw in the control sticks and you're off to the races. Now, speaking of controllers with built-in display, if you have one of these, an RC Pro controller, a controller which costs $1,200 to purchase, you'll be very sad to learn that this controller will not work on the DJI Air 3.
What?
But we're hoping DJI will introduce some kind of firmware update to make it compatible one day. But I wouldn't hold my breath. Now, I think it's really cool that a technology that lets you remotely pilot your drone from 20 kilometers away exists in 2023. And it always makes me feel like we're living in the future. But reality is often very different from the spec sheet. And in reality, with Occusync 4, we've found that you're most likely going to get 5 to 10 kilometers depending on your environment and how obstructed you are at your location.
No signal.
And as you can see, both of these controllers lost their signal at around the 5 km mark, which means you're going to get the same kind of performance that you're already getting from Occusync 3. The only real difference that we've noticed is that when you're flying the Mavic 3 and the Air 3 together, the RC Pro controller could sometimes get a bit of signal interference when you're standing too close with the DJI-RC2. We don't really know why this has happened, but we like to think that maybe Occusync 4 might be transmitting a stronger signal. If you have gone through a similar issue, please share with us your experience in the comment section below. Now, to really understand who this drone is designed for, we'll have to talk about price. And to do that, we've selected the cheapest configuration for each drone. The DJI Air 3 with the RCN2 controller retails for $1,100. The Mavic 3 Pro with the DJI RC controller retails for $2,200. And finally, the Mini 4 Pro with the RCN2 controller retails for $760. Now, if you're a beginner looking to get your first drone and you don't want to have to register that drone, look no further. The DJI Mini 4 Pro is the drone for you. It's got the same obstacle avoidance sensors as the other two to help you avoid crashing on your first flight. And it's a really easy drone to fly. And you still get all the smart features like active track, quick shots, and hyperlapse, just like what you will get on the Air 3 and Mavic 3. Your camera quality, however, will just be as good as the Air 3, and this is because they both use the same sensor. And while you don't have to register your drone because it weighs less than 250 grams, it is also because of that 250 grams that your Mini 4 Pro is a bit underpowered and more susceptible to strong winds. However, as long as you don't plan on flying during windy conditions, you'll be perfectly fine. And even then, when you do get into trouble, the smaller drone is generally cheaper to fix. And if you have DJI Care Refresh, you can ask DJI for a replacement for only $65. How good is that? Now, if you're looking for the best camera drone with the best image quality, then you need to go for the Mavic 3 Pro. The image quality that it produces is mind-blowing, and so is the price that you'll have to pay. At $2,200, it's double the price of the Air 3, but in essence, underneath it all, the Mavic 3 Pro is the same drone as the DJI Air 3, only fatter. They both have got omnidirectional sensors, the same flight time and battery life, and it's even got the same top speed. It's just that the Mavic 3 Pro has got a better camera and a bigger price tag to match. And if you were to crash the Mavic 3 Pro, the repair bill and the replacement fee for the DJI Care Refresh is also going to be big. So this leaves us with the question, who is the DJI Air 3 for? And to answer that, we'll have to talk about Porsches. Now, if you're familiar with Porsches, you'll know that the 911 is the creme de la creme of Porsche's lineup, and it's often priced 3 times more expensive than the cheapest sports car that Porsche makes, the Porsche Boxster. And as you can see, there's a fairly big gap here in the market between these two cars. Porsche knows this, and they know that there is demand in there for something priced in the middle. So rather than leaving that market gap empty to be dominated by other brands, Porsche got their engineers to create a car that was cheaper than a 911, that drives almost like a 911, but it could never beat a 911. And this is how the Porsche Cayman was born. Which is what the DJI Air 3 is. It's DJI's Porsche Cayman. A drone designed to fill the market gap, designed to be just as good as the Mavic 3, but not quite. So, does this make the DJI Air 3 an inferior drone? No. Not really. It may be a lesser drone than the Mavic 3, but only in terms of camera quality. And like we've said earlier, they both have the same safety feature, the same battery life, the same top speed. It's just that the Air 3 is a bit skinnier. And so is the price tag. And it's actually because of the price tag that the DJI Air 3 is designed for more people than the Mavic 3 Pro. It's the perfect all-rounder. And it can even be a beginner's drone. The only problem is that you'll have to register it. Aww. Now, if you don't need the flexibility of the dual camera setup and maybe you have an extra $500 to spare, there's always the Mavic 3 Classic, which will give you access to the amazing 4/3 sensor. But it will cost you $1,600. So, we hope we've cleared things up for you and that some of our ramblings made some sense. And if you found this video to be helpful, please don't forget to leave us a thumbs up, because it really helps a small channel like ours get discovered. And of course, please do subscribe so you can stay tuned for more videos like this. Thank you for watching. We'll catch you in the next one. Bye.